I fear are the final years for lovers of things chicken fried. We are besieged on one side by the health conscious, for whom lard is the new cigarette, and on the other side by hacks and heretics, who deep fry our sacred dish and call it country fried steak. But for all its fiber fascists and drum circles, Austin is still home to a small remnant who know you're never closer to God than when you're eating chicken fried steak. People who choose a shorter life with gravy over a longer life without it.
And for we, the final lovers of beef and batter, there is no safer place than a bowling alley.
You'll find the Dark Bowl Steakhouse in north central Austin. From Mopac, exit 2222 and head east. Just past First Texas Honda, hang a right on Grover. The Dart Bowl will be to your right. Parking's a snap. You'll find a nice-sized car lot. Just park wherever you like. Facing the building, you'll see the main entrance and then another entrance to the right. Choose that right side entrance. It's closer to the cafe. Walk inside and turn to your right. You'll be tempted to bowl immediately, but stay the course. Just a few paces away from the door is our destination.
If you wait for a hostess to seat you, you're gonna wait a long time. Just find yourself a table and have a seat. That's how it's done here. If you're here for lunch, this grease-stained scrap of paper is the menu. You'd do well to study it before the waitress comes to visit. But come on, you're here for the chicken fried steak.
How are you doing today?
Just dandy.
You've
probably noticed that most places serve either Coke or Pepsi products. That's a function of cost. You get a better deal if you go with one brand over the other. Fortunately, most places, whether they're a Coke or Pepsi shop, serve Dr. Pepper, including the Dark Bowl. Me? I'll have iced tea. It's the table wine of the South.
Here you go.
Thank you.
What are you gonna have today?
Remember that grease-stained scrap of paper on the table that turned out to be the menu? For the love of all things good and decent, give it a read before she comes over. There are plenty of restaurants in this town with college-aged waitresses trained to recite to you the day's sides. The Dart Bowl is not one of them. You get three sides. Know what you want in advance. Show some leadership. They smell your weakness. The Dart Bowl does fries just how I like. Very fresh, skins on, thick cut. That's why when I get the chicken fried steak, I get it with fries, fries, and fries. Marty, he likes the vegetables. I wouldn't know about the vegetables because I'm a man and not a boy. That's what allows me to order triple fries. At lunch, the meal is served with homemade rolls. At dinner, the meal comes with homemade bread. Both are delicious. I slightly prefer the bread. The menu claims that for a small surcharge, you can get bread instead of rolls at lunch. No waitress has ever allowed me to do this. I'm always strongly discouraged. I don't know what the reason is, and I'm not gonna dig into it. Every element on this plate is perfect. The gravy, the batter, the meat, and the fries. Let's take a moment to appreciate this bread. Clearly, it's been buttered, but they serve it with an additional side of butter, I'd say about a tablespoon. Does anyone in your life love you this much? All right, let's try this chicken fry. You get through it with the fork pretty easily. That's so good. We've got a fry here with a little bit of gravy on it. This is really fantastic.
Right there in that same shopping center.
Man. I've got to know who made this.
My name's Peggy Zamaripa. I'm the manager. And I've worked here 32 years. And I cook.
Peggy is solid gold. Shortly after the Dart Bowl opened, Butch and his dad, the original and current owners, hired our girl here as a waitress. After 10 years or so of serving folks like you and me, Peggy took an interest in the kitchen. Butch and Dad swore her to secrecy and taught her the ways of the Force. And when I say secrecy, I mean people who love the Dart Bowl ought to keep Peggy safe, secrecy. We asked her which of the Dart Bowl's recipes are kept in the Chamber of Secrets.
the gravies, of course the breading on our chicken fries, and one of the big things, the homemade chili. So that was one of the major. And of course the vegetables, the way they're cooked. They're canned vegetables, some of them, but it's not just canned, it's just how I doctor it up.
And yes, that was in fact the bulk of the menu. God gave Austin the Dart Bowl in 1959. The original location was on Burnett Road. Today, the former address of the Dart Bowl, like everything else on Burnett Road, is now a furniture store. The Dart Bowl moved to Grover Lane in 1996. The regulars were grieved to move their home away from home. So the owners elected to let the restaurant family write notes on a panel of wall, and then they moved that panel of wall to the current location. Here it is. Today, you'll find third-generation regulars at the Dart Bowl Cafe. I find comfort in that.
Why is the gravy yellow?
That's a secret. I can't tell you.
Okay. One more note about the food here. Many, many fine people whom I respect come here not for the chicken fried steak, but for the enchiladas. And I have to agree, they are delicious. So, medical science being what it is, I'll probably survive my first heart attack. I think I'll go ahead and get myself some. One more note. You can take these beauties right down to the lanes with you when you roll. This chili smells fantastic. I'm gonna try and do this and not soil my shirt. Those are fantastic. So, you know, if you're worried that bowling has the slight taint of physical activity, offset any positive value with bites of chili and cheese between rolls. Eating so much can make you start to feel bad about yourself, make you feel dirty. Thankfully, the Dart Bowl has a full bar where you can wash those feelings right away. I like to do it with some OJ, grenadine, and tequila. It's called a tequila sunrise. Thank you. So that's the Dart Bowl Steakhouse off 2222 on Grover. Come for the chicken fried steak, come back for the enchiladas. If you see me here when you come in, feel free to pick up my tab. I don't think I'll ever say it better than that. Okay. That is a mouthful.
Jack didn't know what he was getting into.
That's really funny. That's some jam them Duke boys are in.
Here comes the tea. Y'all want to do it?
I thought there was a cut before I said that. This is what TV's like.